Another one. See, there's 5 A's, and then, so it was a way to try to get different comedy ideas out there that would work best in this medium. Yeah, that's why. Yes.
Do you actually play the guitar?
Do I actually play the guitar? Said with a very accusatory tone. Like, hey, we don't need bullshit guitar players coming down this course. I picked up on that. So yes. I do actually play the guitar a little bit, but I don't. Can I demonstrate?
Yeah.
Without a guitar, I cannot demonstrate. But if I had one right now, I don't know if that would be cool or just the worst thing ever. But, oh, travels around with a guitar. Okay, I think I'm done. So I have a little guitar at home. The one that I played in Flight of the Conchords is not mine. That was a professional guitar. Kind of hard to find a guitar, an affordable guitar. The guitars, there aren't that many, so I think the price has gone way up. Those things are scarce. But I do like the idea of somebody who plays guitar regularly, like when he wants to practice. He could play a keyboard, but this guy is going to wear the keyboard at home and guitar it. Yeah, so I play a little bit, but it's not my... I don't write on guitar. That's not my instrument of choice, my default. Anybody else want to talk about anything here? Yes?
Do you have a favorite joke from a different comedian or a friend or anything like that?
Do I have a favorite joke from a different comedian? Or a friend or anything like that. One of my favorite jokes that I played on myself was law school. It was a long, expensive, difficult joke. It was about a two-year joke. Only now it's a favorite, later. But while I was doing it, I was like, this isn't funny at all. I don't know, I kind of, you guys are probably similar. Jokes are weird because the shelf life isn't so good on a joke the way it might be on other things in life. So the first time you hear a joke, I think the surprise part of it is so much of what makes it enjoyable. And whether it's a new joke that I've thought of or a friend's joke I've heard for the first time, it's only in the beginning that I really can like it that way. And then after a while, I can still like it, but not in the same magical way. It's probably like the way a relationship shouldn't be. Do you know what I mean? That honeymoon period with the joke, and then it's over, and then you're like, oh, you, yeah. This joke about farts, what else? So it's very time-based. It would probably just be for the last nice joke I heard, the good joke I heard from somebody else. I do like jokes that are short and simple. Is that okay? What happened? All right. I tend to like shorter jokes, though. Buzz? Yes?
What do you do when people ask you awkward questions?
I usually just kind of ramble for a bit, and I say, That wouldn't be creepy at all. I'm almost 40. Hey, so when's your prom? When is it?
June 5th.
Really? I'm not going to be in town. I would consider such a thing, but I do think it would be it might be a little weird.
Maybe a little.
A little bit, just because not a lot of people. I don't think I'm an actual celebrity where people would be like, oh my god, and be like, who is that guy? I mean, maybe a few of your friends would be like, oh right, the comedian. Oh, that's funny. But other people would be like, what's the deal with the Jason Schwartzman wannabe? What? She asked me. I'm 37. What's the problem? Breakdancing? Yeah, I can do that. Oh, you were joking. I'm going to go now. Okay. Yes?
Which do you like better, the LA or New York stand-up scene?
Which do I like better, the LA or New York stand-up scene? I did stand-up in New York for 13 years. That's where I started. So I'm going to say New York because I know it better and there are more rooms, you know, where you can get up and stuff. LA, there are some pretty good rooms. The other thing is, I've learned now, living in Santa Monica near LA, when you bomb, I do a show and I bomb, right? Like right now, see how that sounds? You bomb, and then you have to drive home, it's so much worse than when you bomb. Like in New York, if I had a bad set or I bombed, I could like curse and leave and just like kick a bag of garbage or like look at a homeless guy and be like, all right, I'm doing better than him. Whatever it was, something would make me feel better. You know, when you could get drunk or something and then just get in a cab. But in LA, if you bomb, you then have to still responsibly, like, go find your car and get inside it. And back out and don't hit the other cars, you know, and then drive on the road. And then you're just alone in the car, just sitting with how crappy you did tonight. And then there might be traffic, and you're like, I can't believe I have to drive all the way home. I had to commute to fail. This is crazy. This is terrible. So yeah, I prefer New York in that sense. Yes? Yes. My favorite band is the Beatles. I know that's an easy answer, but I really do love the Beatles. The Beatles is the only band I think I can just keep going back to and being in awe of and surprised by how much stuff they did. Plus, if I'm trying to learn how to play drums and I listen to the Beatles just for drumming, I'm like, God, I feel like Ringo Starr is so underrated. And especially on that first John Lennon album I've been listening to lately, Plastic Ono Band. You guys know? I love like a lot of the drumming on that. And who else do I like? You know, lately I just got a record player, so I've been listening to. There's a record store near my house, so I've been just buying old records that are really cheap. What I like about vinyl is that you can find stuff that wasn't considered important enough, I guess, or popular enough to go into CD, and then maybe onto the internet. Excuse me, so you can find all this weird stuff. So, I got a couple of ragtime guitar albums that are really interesting to listen to, just to try to figure out what they're doing. Flamenco guitar, and. What else? Just kind of guitar stuff. So, not the coolest. Do you have a favorite band?
Probably Pink Floyd.
Pink Floyd? Cool. Yeah, so we're both living in the past. We're smart. We're not. Yes?
Because of your commentary about the shelf life of jokes, does that mean your book will go to paperback sooner?
So, because of my commentary on the shelf life of jokes, does that mean my book is going to go to paperback sooner? If you rip the cover off, it's paperback right now. It comes with a paperback inside, which a lot of people don't realize. I don't know. This is designed to have a very good shelf life. And it's extra flammable. If you don't like it, you can just burn it right away, which is kind of nice. I try to be very conscious of that. Biodegradable, the whole thing. Probably delicious, too. Why did my show get canceled? That hurts me. I think my show got canceled because sometimes things are too good, and they make other people feel lousy about the stuff they're making. Well, a couple of friends have mentioned that that's a common thing in the business, so I'm going to take the word. The second season, I don't think it was promoted in a way that people could understand. I think I remember talking to Comedy Central about this, and I was like, you guys aren't going to just do ads that say Demitri and Sarah. I was like, people are going to think that's a show. You know, I did the show last year and it has a name. Why don't we just go with the name of the show and the same kind of graphics so people can at least learn what this thing is? They're like, our marketing people know what they're doing, okay? They're marketing, so just let them do their marketing. Yeah, but it's... Please, just let us market it, okay? And then those Demitri and Sarah ads went up and I got all these messages from people. Do you have a new show called Demitri and Sarah with Sarah Silverman? Are you guys doing a show together? I said, no, I don't. And I was like, Comedy Central, see? But by then, I was already kicked out of the offices and it was canceled. So there's no response. I'm sorry, it was gone. So that's a sad, true answer. I should have gone with the other answer. Okay.
What's the most awkward moment you've had while doing stand-up comedy?
What's the most awkward moment I've had while doing stand-up? Do book tours count? Just stand-up? One of the awkward moments I've had, I mentioned this to, I told an audience this once before, but it's true. Like 2 years ago, I got a corporate gig in Mexico. So a corporate gig is a company will hire you. How you doing? Just give me a thumbs up. Company will hire you. Sometimes a company will hire a comedian to come and perform at dinner, say, for a bunch of, in this case, winners. People who sold the most software in this company got to go to Mexico and go to this resort for a weekend, and I was the entertainment the one night. So they fly me down there, and I get to stay at this nice hotel. And then the night comes, the next night, they bring me down to the showroom, which was a tent. It was a tent on the beach. So here's the thing with comedy. My rule with comedy is the worse a room is in a fire, the better the room is for comedy. This is great. There's a rug, books, we're surrounded, it would be hard to get out. Like, this is a good, it's got a good feel to it for comedy. A basement, like a crowded basement, you know what I mean? That's good. This show was in a tent on a beach. That's bad, right? There's sand and water. That's bad in a fire. No, good in a fire, bad in comedy, I got it. And it's a tent, you know, there's a breeze, you can get away easily, so I'm thinking, this is going to be terrible. So I go down, they introduce me, there are like 350 people, these round tables, and I came out, and with comedy, what I find is that in the first minute or so, you can tell if you're in trouble. You can tell if this crowd's not going to like you, if it's going to be a fight, what's going to happen. So sure enough, 1 minute into my hour, silence. I mean, I'm in trouble. This is going to be bad. About 2 minutes later, I started hearing something. Now you got to understand, a tent on the beach in Mexico at night is a place where there's wildlife. This beach in Mexico is not developed like a lot of the beaches in New Jersey where I'm from. There's like different kind of wildlife. We have guidos, they're called. But this has a wildlife. So I'm bombing and it's quiet. I mean, it's quiet, and I suddenly hear crickets. I could actually hear crickets. There were crickets on the beach. So now I'm actually hearing crickets bombing. I mean, 350 people, that's a lot of chances to find somebody who might find you funny. 350, we're talking five people. I'm talking 350 people. Silence. Crickets. Which then is amazing, right? I'm like, I tell the audience, do you guys hear that? I'm hearing crickets. Nothing. Silence. And that's, I'm talking 5-10 minutes in there. So I'd still do like 50 minutes of that. So that was one of the most awkward in recent memory. A lot of awkward ones, but that was one of them. And then what was worse was the next day, I was at the pool. I was hanging out in one of those little lounge chairs. And this guy just goes by in the pool. It's like one of those like wading pools that goes around the kind of resort. And this jerk just goes by with this like straw hat and sunscreen on his nose. I'm just lying there minding my own business, and he just goes by slowly and he looks at me and he goes, I thought you were funny. I just wanted to drown him. I just wanted to take that hat and put it on the cover. I thought you couldn't breathe. Very mean. That's why comedians don't like to do cruise ships, because if you bomb on the cruise ship, you can't go anywhere. No, ugh, there's the comedian. Terrible, not my cup of tea. Then you're stuck there for another 5 days. So that was a pretty bad one. Anything else? Yes?
What's your favorite funny movie?
What's my favorite funny movie? One movie that I really loved from when I was a kid is, I think it's The Pink Panther Strikes Again. I always forget which one it is, but Peter Sellers is one of my favorite comedy actors. I just think he was such a brilliant, funny guy. And when I was a kid, my father showed us the Pink Panther movies, the original ones with Peter Sellers. That's one of the few things for me that was funny when I was like 7, and it's still funny like 30 years later. I still find it so funny. So those are my favorite things, I think. The things that I found funny then that still somehow make me laugh. Whether it's for the same reason or I don't know what, it's nostalgia or something. But in that one, it's the one where he's in this like castle and he goes on the parallel bars and then he dismounts and he falls down the stairs. So you should look at him on YouTube.